Viewer to my YouTube channel. I am Anusha. In this video we are going to learn about J-meter functions, which is very important part of J-meter learning. So you can find these functions in tools section, function helper dialog box here. So let us start by adding a thread group. Let's add a simple dummy sampler here. Then add a listener. Okay. So let us see how the function look like. Function looks like this in JMeter. Function name and the variable values like this. So there are multiple functions which can be found here. So in this section, so these are the multiple functions: counter, date, time, random variable, random number we want, random screen, random string we want, groovy function. Multiple functions are available here, random date, and we can use this as per our requirement. So let us see an example how to use this. So in this, I want to send username, login with the username, password, and we want to send time also. Let's see. So this is my login dummy sampler. Okay, now let's start with one by one functions. I want to start my username. I want it to be unique, and I am going to set a counter function here to make it unique in terms of value. So let's see the counter function. So true for each user to have own counter. We don't want that. So writing false. Name of the variable I want to be counter, user counter, and then I'm generating this particular function. So this is a function which is generated, and we can see current JMeter values, variable values also. So I have copied this and I'm using it here. Next, I want the password to be random. So I want to add a pass as a paraphrase, and then I want to use the random function. So let's see how we can use this. Random, the minimum value say 5 to 200, and random password is my variable value. So generate, copy this function, use this function. And next we want time here. So for time, let's see what all options we have. We have time shift. Let's use time function. Okay, this is how the date is displayed here, date and time. So I'm using this function as is. Okay, let us see how it works. So saving this here. And let's see. Press run. Okay, so in the request we can see user 1, password is getting randomly generated, and time is given. So now I want to add some response here. So what I want to add here is a token value. Then you can use a groovy function as well here. Okay, so any groovy function which you write, you can call it here. Okay. all these functions here in terms of whatever you want to use. So let's use a function new string builder. What I want to do here is append. I want to append this counter user, whatever we are getting here. Then we want to append random password. Then we want to append here. That time. Okay. So we have added this particular Groovy function, and now let's run the test. So in the response we can see the token generated here as per our requirement. Now we can add function inside another function. So for that, let us see how we can do it. I'm adding here a lock function. And I want to print this token inside the log also. Now let's run with the log function. Let's see the log. So yeah, the token is visible in the logs as well. So these are some samples of function helper in JMeter. Try to use different functions in JMeter and let me know any doubts if you have in the comment section below. Do subscribe my channel and comment the next topic on which you want to see the video. You can comment about any tools, any new language or anything you want. Do share your feedback as well. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.